Uros, what do you think has been the key to the inside production for Tennessee the last couple of games?
I just feel like everybody, all of our big guys, I feel like buying into our role and what we need to do, you know, and coach put a lot of emphasis on rebounding lately. So we're trying to be the best rebounding team in the country. And I think we are there offensively, but defensively we still have a lot of work to do. I think all of our bigs are putting a lot of effort into it every single game. So, but I think it starts in practice. So we compete against each other every single day in practice and on the glass, on both ends of the floor. And I think that is giving results lately.
We've also scored a lot between you and Olivier and Aidoo and so forth. Y'all have been scoring a lot more points.
Well, I think that comes from our guards trusting us, giving us the ball, and also coach, you know, trusting our guards that they're going to get the ball to us and us finish the ball around the rim. But, you know, I just feel like that also comes from practice and us, you know, working really hard on it and, you know, in our daily vitamins, doing extra reps and making sure that we get ball high off the glass and, you know, just finish those little bunnies around the rim.
Coach talked about how valuable Josiah has been for you guys on the floor. I mean, you feel that too when he's out there?
Absolutely. Josiah is a huge piece of our team, and, you know, just everybody talking about Josiah being a glue guy, and he really is. He puts everybody, he brings everybody together, everybody closer, and, you know, he always makes sure that people know people are on the same page, and I miss Josiah. I'm really happy that he is back playing, and, you know, this, what we've seen from Josiah so far since he's been back is nothing compared to, you know, what Josiah can bring to this team and what he has done in the past few years since, you know, he'd be here. So really excited to see what the future holds for him.
What's the last month or so been like for you with Jonas and Tobe growing into bigger roles?
It's been really fun, honestly. Just having, like, more people in that spot, you know, sharing those minutes, keeping people fresh. And, you know, I think that gives us more opportunities to, you know, like, be better, you know, like, work harder on the court, just because you know that there is somebody coming in for you that is going to do exact same thing, you know, like, we're not going to go, you know, like, if you go to the bench, like, we're not getting any worse, we're just getting better.
What's Zakai been doing so well as a facilitator these last couple games?
You know, I just feel like Zakai, you know, coming in the game and changing the you know, the whole dynamic and speed of the game. And, you know, when everybody's tired, just Zakai comes in fresh, ready to go. And, you know, I don't think there's anybody in the league that can control his speed. But at the same time, he sees the floor really well, and he connects people on the floor. He's our true point guard. So I think he's done a really good job with that.
What do you remember about Vanderbilt last year? I feel like you had some big buckets down the stretch in that game last year.
That was last year. I think we should just focus on the game that is tomorrow. And, you know, Vanderbilt is always a tough opponent. You know, they really like play against us, I would say. And, you know, we always get their best shot. We just got to make sure that we give them our best shot. So,
Heroes Coach Barnes called you out recently about your antics. What was your reaction to that?
He was 100% right about it. You know, that is something that, you know, I need to fix on my own, and, you know, something that I have to control better. But I think I've done a better job lately, and, you know, that is something that I don't want to do to hurt the team. But, you know, that was something that just came out of adrenaline and, you know, passion for the game, I would say. But I just need to focus on, you know, using that energy and putting it towards some other things on the court.
Do you think you've been more productive since then?
Absolutely. Yeah, I had a long talk with Coach, and, you know, he's here to help me. Everybody's here to help, you know, our guys. So, you know, he came to me. We talked about it, and that was definitely something I needed to change. And I'm still working on it, and I'll keep working on it.
How good is this team at taking a scouting report and executing it?
What is that again?
A scouting report. I mean, that info and executing it.
Yeah, that is obviously a huge part. You have to know personnel because, you know, we have a few different, say, ball screen coverages, and, you know, if that is something that you cannot execute every single time. So you have to make sure that you know every single player on the team, what they do, because you're going to end up in a lot of switching situations where you have to guard smaller players, or you have to know if he's a driver, shooter, which sides he likes to go, and all that stuff. So it is really important for everybody to be locked into the scouting report.
What's the line between, I guess, what Coach Barnes called antics and the passion you're talking about?
I just feel like sometimes, obviously he has a line that he don't want me to cross, but, it's just, some non-basketball stuff that, you don't want to see on the basketball court, just maybe getting that quick tech at Arizona or stuff like that, that I definitely need to get out of my game. I would say that stuff also affects me as a player, obviously if you get a tech, you're going to take you out of the game. And then I feel like I started the game off really well at Arizona, and then that kind of threw me out of the game for a little bit. And, it makes you, think about it more and, stuff like this. I just need to be locked in and be out there for my team, get out of my not think about myself, just be there for my teammates. And I think I'm getting there. I think I've done a little bit better job lately.
Rick's been emphasizing with you using the backboard on your shots. How have you seen that really help you the last couple of games offensively?
I think he has helped me a lot, just because, he kept talking about, if you shoot it off the glass, he has a lot more chance to go in than if you don't. I think all of our bigs are starting to use the glass more, and I feel more, comfortable doing it now. Just making more shots, I guess it gives the results. Should listen to him more.
When you see Jonas Aidoo attempt a three-pointer, you expect it to go in?
100% every single time. I know how much he has worked on it over the summer and how much time he put into it. So there's not a single person on our team that is going to give a different answer. It feels good, it looks good, and if it doesn't go in, we just got to go get it.
How much would you say the post has improved from the start of preseason practice to today?
I would say a lot, but at the same time, I would say that there is still a lot of room for improvement for, every single of our post guys. And obviously, Olivia's done a great job lately, Tobe and Jonas. I still feel like that us competing against each other every single day in practice is, just something that, I would say it's even of the level of the competition that we get every single game, if not better.
Thank you.
Thank you, guys.
Novak Djokovic.